Hey guys, it's Cameron from Desert RC, and today I'm doing buggy things with my buddy Logan from West Desert Wheeler. But let's get out on the rocks and do some fun four-wheel steer buggy lines.
Each other. And so it's triangulated all the way from top and bottom.
Okay.
Real time.
Yeah, just kind of zone in to watching it conform. I don't even know if I can get myself up this. Yeah, I was trying to swing it with Wyatt to like go down there and see if you were interested in going, but when I heard they only have an invite of 30 people, I was like, what's the point? It's like special invite only. And what are the odds, you know? There's people with some really serious builds going there, and I can't really compete.
If I built a car and didn't get an invite, I'd be pissed.
Oh, yeah. My plan was to convert this to 1.9 drag axle, and with the whole wagon that I'm working on, I was going to put all of this under it, or maybe Capra axles to get that width. But at that point, I was like, I'm not even going to rush myself. Got a lot going on. It's in April, I believe. Mm-hmm. I also don't know if I'd be able to make it, because that's when my busy season is for my work. Oh, I think I want to go to the left.
Tough exit out the top.
Yeah. Nice.
That's so sick.
Oh.
Thanks for
coming. Get back in there. That's why I put my remote down. I was like, I need to have a free hand in case this comes down at me. You got this.
I don't know if I do.
I was further this way before I tried to pull my rears up. You were more in that crack, but we'll see. It's also your second time out with this car, right? First time after rebuilding it?
First time after rebuilding it. I've had it out a few times.
Okay. There you go. Oh yeah. Drift car status. Now, speaking of which, I picked myself up a drift car. I'll nice. Be here by Thursday.
Sick, what'd you get?
I ended up getting a Ravity RDX, fully built. Like, nice. I bought it secondhand. No way I'm gonna spend money on a new one and have to upgrade everything, you know? But I went out once with Wyatt, and I drove his like beginner car. I was like, all right, this is fun. And then I drove his, I was like, all right, I'm hooked. Like, I gotta get one. It's kind of like the same technical feeling you get from the... And next I've got the Promoto for sale, so we'll see if I can get rid of that thing.
Saw that as well.
Yeah. I mean, it was fun, but it's just not the same kind of fun as RC Drift. Yeah, the other thing we have to consider is your tires aren't even scrubbed in yet. And it's doing really well for non-scrubbed in G8s. Yeah, between all of our cars, it takes such a long time to break in some tires now. Like, it took me 6 months to break in those cut and shuts that you made for me. Thank you. a lot higher than I want to be. I kind of want to be lower, like over by where I'm at, but. Nice. That was a good one. It's where it helps to have that narrower axle like the F10. The high overdrive screwing me up. Oh, backwards, yeah. Solar glare. Get out of here, son. Just a bunch of solar glare. I'm good here. I know I'm in a vulnerable position right now in front of you. Don't get any ideas. I think I need to get on the other side.
I'm about to take a picture.
Oh, good thing I got out of there.
That's a big ledge.
Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna, for the safety of my rig, I'm gonna pull out of that one.
That was a net.
Yeah, you're already in a better spot than I was. Nice. There it is.
Powerful dramatic effect for you.
Yeah, just keep pushing the front over. Prices might do it though. Maybe a hot day with a scrubbed in tire too. Yeah, yeah, another quarter inch of wheelbase. So close. All right, let's pass that one. Yeah, we'll do one at a time because it gets kind of tight in here. Prices might be perfect for that. Damn, missed it. Oh, there it goes, it's picking up. You have the 400?
800s.
800s, oh wow. The SLW hubs.
Oh, those are four 350s.
Okay, yeah, I think I'm running four. I can't remember what the 400 one is. 475s, yeah.
Shit, dude.
Man, it's possible.
A narrow car did it.
Yeah. Awesome. I'll send my Speedy through there next.
Yeah.
That's the least of your worries, though. take a lunch break right there. Nice. I'm liking that. Oh, I have no rear shear right now. There we go. I can see the difference right there once I get to that hole.
I let my front slip under and I was able to recover.
On the driver's side?
Yep.
Problem is when I get into a bind like that, my steering will like force itself in the direction where the bind is.
So you're not turning left?
No.
That's really weird.
Yeah, see?
Because mine will freeze, but they usually don't turn.
See, I can't even turn my rear right now. There we go.
Yeah, I'm not surprised when it does that. Because mine will do the same thing.
Okay. This is no joke trying to film this at the same time.
Yeah, no doubt, no doubt.
Those of you watching this, you guys have no idea how hard it is trying to film one-handed and do rear steer with your middle finger and thumb.
I have an idea.
Yeah, you know. And anybody else that makes YouTube videos. All right, guys, thanks for watching if you've made it this far. If you aren't subscribed, please do that already if you wouldn't mind. Helps out the channel big time. We have some good content coming in the future. Gonna be swapping rigs with Logan from West Desert Wheeler. And he's gonna take the bug bite, and I'm gonna take his capper for the day, and we're just gonna drive each other's rigs. But we'll catch you guys next time. See you guys next week.